Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh,
James Thomas is here to tell it like it is. Here to talk education, politics, business. James is here for real talk without the yelling. Real issues and solutions. This is Tell It Like It Is with James Thomas on 1300 WTLS and 106.5 FM. Online at 1300WTLS.com.
Welcome to Tell It Like It Is. I'm your host, James Thomas, and I have two very special guests on Medical Mondays, brought to you by the Central Alabama Veterans Healthcare System, Ian Reed and Karen Boswell. How you doing?
Doing good. How about you?
Welcome to the show. Karen, you know you've been on the show before. I want to thank you for coming back. And Ian, is over the homeless program for the VA system.
Yes, that's correct.
Well, Karen, we want to get with you. We're going to start with Ian. Ian, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Ian Reed, from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. I've been with the cabinets on this VA since 2010, so about 7 years. Background is in social work. Before I came to the VA, I was working with juvenile sex offenders as a family vet. I'm transitioning here. I started with the substance program, which actually allowed me to really interact with a lot of the homeless veterans throughout the world. And from that transition to the homeless program in 2013, worked as an outreach social work group, reading streets, and went to the permanent housing program, the BASH program. That's it, just kind of just solely helping people who don't do the system.
And Karen, you're no stranger to the show, but let's go ahead and reintroduce you to our audience again.
Well, thank you. I've been with the VA for 16 years now. I started off in the post-traumatic stress disorders clinic. And from there, worked in the mental health clinic with a variety of veterans with a variety of different mental health issues. And from there, I became the program manager for services for veterans returning from the war in Iraq and Afghanistan. Since 2008, I've been working with the suicide prevention program.
Now, suicide, homelessness, almost go hand in hand. I know it was some years ago. Matter of fact, it was many years when I started out in Detroit. We did a special on homeless veterans that were actually living out on the streets. In Detroit, we had a great deal of them. And we actually went from Detroit to Ohio, Illinois, and Indiana. And it was amazing. But during that time where I was able to interview some of these homeless vets, during that week's span, I know of four of those individuals that we actually interviewed actually committed suicide. So it was tough because I didn't realize how many vets actually are homeless. And it was for a veteran and myself, it was tough. In a way, I understand why a lot of them have problems transitioning back. But it was tough. It was tough for me to see them in that situation. But I want to applaud and thank you guys for what it is you do for our veterans, because believe it or not, you guys are, we need you a lot. Right? I know from experience being a combat veteran, it's tough. It's tough out there. Tell us a little bit about the homeless program and what it is you actually do for that program.
Well, I'm actually the active program manager right now. So in the short sense, what I try to do is make sure that my team, just my role, to make sure my team as necessary resources to help veterans, to help our homeless veterans. But some of the things that we do change is that first thing we want to identify is for a husband, very good thing we want to find you. We want to identify you. We want to get you in because we know it's tough. Now, if you share, we share briefly your experience how tough it is. We want to make it as less tough as possible and an easy transition for you to go from being homeless to a permanent house. If that's what you want, or no, true, you know, if that's what you want, you know, we want to always acknowledge that every veteran has a choice. You know, some of them come from living with family,
right?
Some of them want to have their own place, and that's what you want. We want to help you get there. We do it through a number of ways. You know, we identify you first, then we want to assess you. We want to see what are your immediate needs versus your long-term needs. Definitely want to link people with wraparound services. So if your need is substance abuse, if your need is mental health, if you have had some past suicidal ideations or some past, you know, attempts, we want to link you with people like him,
right?
Because they need to be a part of your care plan for yourself to make it a little less stressful. It doesn't mean that you still won't have stress.
Right.
It just means you have some options of how you want to manage the stress.
Now, you mentioned earlier that you identify
contracts with homeless shelters here in Montgomery. So if we get a homeless veteran and we want to get them in, we have a bed open, we can send them into that bed. So they'll have someone to stay for a long period of time until we help them stabilize.
Right. Now, when you say a bed, that's here at the cabin?
No, it's out in the community. We have a safe haven program. It's kind of located in the old home there.
Right. Here.
It's a 25-hour. It's actually 30 bed facility for our homeless veterans. They provide food, transportation, medical monitoring, medication monitoring. They have a nurse on staff. They transport our veterans to the VA every day for their appointments. If they want to take them back to their shipment, they can stay there anywhere from 4 to 6 months, depending on the diagnosis that they have. And in a program like that, that gives us the opportunity to work with them and help them get rid of the transition to permanent housing. Or help you get ready to transition to our inpatient mental health program, or possibly a substance abuse program, or possibly employment. You know, it's, you know, but the biggest thing, when we get our veteran, we want to try to stabilize. We want to get you stable. So we can provide them another wraparound service to help you be successful like you want to be.
Right. And Karen, we're going into some serious holidays now. And those holidays, I know. This is a very special month because this is the time when we were literally, a lot of people don't really probably forgot, but this is that time we were actually in country on Desert Storm. Between August 2nd and August 12th was a real big, tough time, but guys like myself that has been over there in the week of July was already in country. Because of our specialty, it was tough. It was tough. So I know going into these holidays is real tough and probably active for you guys, considering there's a lot of suicidal thoughts around this time.
An anniversary of when you served in combat can always be a trigger for a veteran. The holidays are triggers for veterans that have served from World War II to present war, because some people, because of their illness, instead of it being a time of celebration with family, it's it's a time of where they want to be with family, but they're isolated from family.
True.
Because
exactly.
For whatever reasons, they're not able to have that joy
right.
that you think everyone should have that's associated with the holidays. And so it can be a very stressful time for people.
Right.
But as Ian talked about, we try to help veterans learn to cope
right.
wherever they are to where they want to be. Most people want to be able to enjoy the holidays with their family members. That's one of the reasons why we have stress management groups, anger management groups, so that veterans can be able to put some of the trauma of the military service in a box away in the corner so that they can enjoy the holidays with their loved ones.
How tough is it?
It can be pretty tough. One of the things that's kind of a misnomer is people think that there are more suicides during the Christmas and New Year's holidays, but actually there are more suicides in the spring.
Right.
And I think that is because winter's gone, and in the wintertime, because the weather's cold and we kind of hibernate and isolate anyway, a lot of us. But in the spring, when everything is starting to bloom again, there's supposed to be whole flowers,
right.
It is when actually statistics show there are actually more suicides. Because everything is brightening up for everybody else, but your life is still gray. But the holidays do have a special hard time for people, especially sometimes Vietnam veterans, when I think about the Tet Offensive,
right.
things of that nature. And so what we try to do is make sure that we're as staff are aware of that, and we try to have just try to emphasize that we are still here for you as a veteran. If you want to come in and talk, they have a walk-in clinic, for example, for the homeless program. We have walk-in clinics for the mental health clinic, so people can know that they can call, they can come in, they can talk to their provider. Of course, we have a 1-800 crisis line number where a veteran, family member, anyone can call when they're feeling like they need to talk to someone, so that we're always available to be there to listen.
You know, what I admire about you guys is how you guys kind of work in unison, that teamwork concept, and that really, I admire that a lot. You guys really seem to have a system in place to where you capture all the needs of a veteran. Ian, do you have that homeless 1-800 number that you can give to our audience?
Sure do. If you know a homeless veteran, they can call 1-877-424-3838. That's our national homeless hotline. Like I said, if they're in our area, we serve from Dothan, back in Montgomery, all the way down to Columbus, Georgia. If they're in our area, they're going to link them to our homeless outreach coordinator. And so we'll make contact with them. We just need the phone number for them. Get back in contact with them. We'll contact them. We'll request them schedule them to go see them.
Is there like a indoctrination or something for veterans when they go into this? How do you guys, you mentioned earlier that you guys assess what their needs are.
Yes, sir.
What type of services of that, besides mental health-wise, is there any other?
Yeah, they may be interested in working. They may have some vocational needs. They may have some social needs. They may want to reconnect with family. That's a need at times. Also, too, in terms of medical, getting the medical service they need, helping them apply for benefits.
Right.
That's one of the primary. A lot of veterans, you still be surprised. A lot of veterans still don't know they're eligible for certain monetary benefits to run yet. So there's a lot of needs between just psychosocial needs, medical needs, financial needs. It's a lot.
Do we have, and I hate to put a number on it, because anytime you say homelessness, one is too many, but do we have a lot of veterans that are homeless in this area, in the Central Alabama region?
We still have a good amount. Currently, right now in Montgomery, we have about 30 veterans right now who are living in our safe haven program. You have to be homeless to be
for our
individuals, so that's 30. We have about probably about 25, 30 in our inpatient program with Tuskegee, in our homeless facility. We also have a few that's in case management in the shelter. So, you know, for us, you know, that's still too.
That's still too.
It's still for us. Now, compared to other cities and places, they may say that's a low number. But for us, it's still too many.
True.
We do, you know, we do have home visitors that come in from different locations every week. So you may have a visitor who may migrate from maybe Washington, D.C.,
right,
Alabama, which home. That does happen. But we serve as the same. That's our mission. For, there's no joke, home visitor walk through our door. We'd be ready to serve them no matter where they come from.
If you know of a homeless veteran or know of a veteran that might be in need of services, please contact the 1-800 number. It's 1-877-424-3838.
Also, to James, let me get our direct number.
Please
call our office. Our direct number to our homeless program is 1-800-214-8387, extension 2549. Another call directly to our homeless program here at Central Alabama Veterans Healthcare System.
Again, that's 1-800-214-8387. 1-800-214-8387, extension 2549, extension. These numbers I will have on our website at talkingalabama.com, so you'll be able to go there if you didn't get a chance to capture those numbers. Karen.
We have a national veterans crisis line. That number is 1-800-273-8255. Veterans can also text the crisis line at 8255. There's also a veterans chat line that they can go on to.
Now, since you and I spoke last, we actually put up the crisis line, the information provided me. So we have that on our website. We continuously have it. I know because we're able to read the click-throughs, we've had some click-throughs and comments that came through that 1-800 number that's on our website. So that number is also posted, but we are adding the homeless on there as well.
We thank you for that.
That's good. That's good. I mean, no, that's not good. it's,
what it means is that people know the service is there.
It's there.
So they're
right,
utilizing
right.
The service. Yeah. We have veterans that call because they are feeling suicidal.
Right.
We have veterans that call because they're concerned about getting refills on their opioid prescriptions,
right,
trying to understand the change that our whole country is making around the use of painkillers.
Right.
We have veterans that call because they're homeless. Because they will call the crisis line because they're homeless, they'll get referred to the homeless program, and they'll get referred to us. So between the two of us, as Ian said, we try to wrap services around them. So veterans can call the crisis line because they can't pay their rent.
Right.
Last week, I had a young lady who finished school using her veterans benefits but had no job. So
right.
She had her benefits in run out because she was no longer in school. She had used the last of her groceries, and she called the crisis. And we were able, because we know resources in the community, to have a couple in Columbus deliver her groceries that night.
Oh, that's good.
And so we try to know who our community partners are, and that's why we had a really successful mental health summit on August 11th. And so we're looking forward to our next program, which is going to be September 15th. And we just want veterans to know that there are services, that there's staff that are here that we want to be able to provide to the services.
Right.
All you need to do is walk in the door. Walk in the door on the call, and the services are available for you.
You know, we started Medical Mondays in order to help educate our veterans and our listeners and audience who knows of veterans that might be in need of various services. And we've had actually a tremendous success. But I also want to let you guys know that this service is for you guys as well. What I mean by that, if you have articles, because we have news articles on our website, you guys can put the information, send it to our producer or myself, and we will actually put that information out, whether it be PSAs, whether it be events or summits, whatever you guys want our veterans to know that they can attend on what's going on. We will be able to get that information out to you guys.
Well, I really appreciate that forum, James, because we are Suicide Prevention Conference on Friday, September 15th at our Tuskegee campus in Building 90, which is often referred to as our canteen.
Right.
It's a large auditorium and we want veterans, it's open to the public, so we want veterans and their families to know that the speakers are going to be addressing issues that they deal with. Our very first speaker is going to be talking about his journey from brokenness to wholeness regarding his military service in Vietnam. The second speaker is going to be talking about treatments for PTSD. The third speaker is going to be talking about treatments for substance abuse. And our fourth presenter is a faculty member at Tuskegee University who's going to be talking about the special challenges for veterans who return to college. So we're very excited about all of those speakers and we want our community partners to come out as well as the veterans to come out so they can learn about the services and the treatments that are available to them.
Now, if we can, I know we have to go through camp, I'm a public affairs person, but if we can get, whether it be the JPEG, if you allow, I know there's some strict guidelines, but if you don't have a PSA and you want us to cut a voiceover of a 30-second PSA about that or 15, we can do that as well. But if I can get that information, we'll go ahead and definitely post that up and let everybody know. Is that something that I would be able to cover, possibly live?
Again, I've talked with our acting public affairs person, and he has agreed he's going to also try to get us some TV coverage for that as well. And so we're hopeful that going through our public affairs, as we're supposed to be following that particular protocol, that media will be allowed to come and know about that. Publicize it and also be there to cover it as well.
Great, and that's going to be in
Tuskegee. That'll be in Tuskegee Friday, September 15th. And Mr. Ian hasn't even been coming up even before then, but I'm sure he's excited to talk about it.
I'm very excited.
Let's get that info out.
We have that annual Homeless Standdown on September 7th and 8th at the Prep Bowl Multiplex. And for those of you who don't know, the Homeless Standdown is a time with the VA hospital. Takes the service from the hospital and bring it to the veteran in the community. So, talk about medical service, mental health screenings, dental screenings, ophthalmology screenings, all in one location. But this year, I'm super excited because our goal for this year's announcement is to actually provide a lot of on the site services.
Right.
So, we don't want veterans walking up just getting ambulance information. We actually want them to be able to get something.
True, at
the stand down. So you'll be able to apply for your Social Security card to stand down. We have veterans, we have Alabama law enforcement agency, they'll be at the stand down, maybe state IDs for veterans. We'll also have our work with Judge Troy Manson. He'll be there at the stand down. He'll be able to kind of help somebody veteran way he like track violations they've done in the past, small misdemeanors.
Right.
Now, the reason why this is so important and so exciting. It's because these are all things that keep a veteran from getting in the house.
That's true.
Or employed. That's true. You don't have the proper ID. How can you get a job? How can you get a apartment? You don't have the proper ID. So these are all things that are barriers. You know, so these barriers. So to have these services in addition to the service the hospital typically brings to the event, it is going to be outstanding. So
that's September 7th.
September 7th and 8th at the Crown Bowl Multiplex downtown.
What's the hours?
Hours from 9 to 2 each day. We'll be feeding homeless veterans that day. So the biggest thing too that the community needs to know is that if you know a homeless veteran they want to come to your event, they need to call 1-800-214-8387 extension 2-5-4-9-8 pre-registered for the event. Yes. Let me tell you why pre-registration is very big, because typically at the event, we average serve 150 veterans at that event. Some of them, most of the veterans are homeless, some of them not homeless.
Right.
But we try not to turn away the veterans that are not homeless, because some of them still need that information too.
Right.
But our priority for those days is to take care of the homeless veteran. So that the homeless veteran will be there that need first.
Right.
They get the items to the free clothing first. They are the priority for both of those days. But we try to open them to other veterans too that they want to
talk.
Because some of the information they may need to, that's fine. We just have to tell them they know before they come through the door. And most times, you know, don't have any issues, but it's going to be a very exciting show. We're going to have a fire different section, a housing section, a legal and benefits section, community resources, a medical section. We're going to have enough space, and we're going to be inside and have additional
work. Right.
Whereas years past, we've been outside,
burning up, that's true.
But so we're very excited. If you know of a homeless veteran, please tell them to either come out, please tell them to call. They can come out. They don't call, they can still walk in.
Right.
We still have eligibility will be there to verify the service. We have homeless social workers on staff to have to do a quick assessment.
Right.
And they can go on in and have access to the services like everybody else.
Now, this is September 7th and 8th.
It's at
Crampton Bowl. Definitely make sure I have that information as well. It's called the Homeless Veteran Standdown. It's going to be at the Crampton Bowl Multiplex. That's 1022 Madison Avenue right here in Montgomery. All kinds of great services will be provided to our homeless vets, and they definitely will have to pre-register for this event. You can do that by calling 1-800-214-8387, extension 2549. Again, that's 1-800-214-8387, extension 2549. Again, this information will also be available on talktoalabama.com. We will make sure that radio station as well, we will, with approval from PR, make sure we keep this information going every day during our wake-up call and during our wake-up call replay, which is 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. So we will broadcast this throughout the day, letting them know about both of the events, Homeless Veteran Standdown and as well as the Suicide Prevention Summit. And, but yeah, this is definitely some great information, because I know this, I've never been to a homeless veteran stand now, so I definitely want to make sure I'm there as well to even talk to some of the vets. Yeah,
okay.
And see how you guys do this. Actually, both of them, I've never been to either one. I've covered a lot of events for the veterans, but I've never been to a homeless or suicide prevention. And I definitely want to be able to cover that. And if I could cover it live, I would be able to broadcast it live, both on the radio on air as well as on our stream services. But back to suicide prevention. That's a real tough one. And it's funny because both of them go hand in hand. And we have a lot of veterans, at least through our association, I served in the Marine Corps. And we are, unlike other services, we are pretty tight, more camaraderie than a lot of other branches of service. And that's mainly because of the size of our group and what we do, you know. So we actually communicate with a lot of veterans throughout the United States. And every year we try to get together and do something for our veterans, or at least for our Marines that we know of. And we've lost a few compared to last year. On that tradition, going into this year, just had a conversation over the weekend, and we lost a few with suicide prevention. It just so happened, of those, I want to say five, two were homeless. And kind of got to a lot of the guys because had we known they were homeless, because of what we do and how we are as brothers, we would have been able to not turn them over to or refer them to the homeless, but we would have made sure that they were taken care of.
Right.
So that it really, a couple of the guys were really down and out. And so we talked over the weekend. I actually shared them about this. Show the date, so I know that those guys are actually viewing it as well.
That's one of the things that we try to talk to members about, is being able to ask for help.
Yeah.
And we have a slogan that says it takes the strength and courage of a warrior to ask for help. So often you all are trying to keep the feelings inside because you have a mission to accomplish. And now your mission has changed. Your mission is not to find and protect. Your mission now is to live and to thrive.
And thrive, you know.
And order to do that, sometimes you have to ask for help. You have to let go of that manly whatever, or female whatever,
right,
that keeps you from asking for help, because services are here. And I talked to a gentleman late Friday evening who did not tell his doctor that after he pays his bills, he's 60% service connected. By the end of the month, he's run out of money for groceries. And I felt bad. I wish I had called him earlier in the day, because I could have gotten him the groceries. But at 6 p.m., all I could do then was look up food banks for Columbus, Georgia,
right,
and give him those 5 resources and tell him this morning by 12, I would call him back to see if he received me.
Right.
And if not, I could pick up the phone or a church in Columbus that would deliver him groceries.
Right.
But again, you have to let people know where you are. If you can't help,
I can tell you from experience, it took me well over 20 years to be able to say that. And just looking back at some of the, I guess, outbursts or reactions that I've done in certain situations, I needed help a long time ago. And it literally took my mom. She passed away some years ago, and she literally called me and said, "James, I need you to go get me today." And it was, you know, because she asked me, and I would never tell her no, nor lie to her, I said, "I'm going to be it." And believe it or not, I've been thankful that I took that step. But it is tough.
It is tough. That's one of the reasons why I'm excited about our first speaker. His name is Mr. Drew. He's going to share his journey. His family had to ask him to leave their home before he could go get help. And so he's going to share what that was like. I'm hopeful that one of his family members will be able to come as well.
Right.
He's going to be honest. He thought everybody else was wrong. Everybody else had the problem. It was not him. Didn't matter how many jobs he'd gone through,
right,
how many marriages he'd gone through. It wasn't him, it was everybody else. And something, he had to have that wake up call.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, I must be really wrong if my wife and children are saying I'm back to leave.
Wow.
And for them to pick him up in the rain one day and have him promise you can come home, but you've got to get some help.
Wow, that is tough.
You know, the great thing about coming to the VA, the great thing about veterans that call and ask for help with the VA is that we're designed to build you. We're trained to understand the issue that you're going to be coming with.
Right.
Not like your family.
Right. True.
Not like your family, not like your friends and your neighbors.
Yeah.
But this group of people here in this building, this environment, they are well trained on what issues. So if the veteran gets to that place of courage, really say, "Hey, I'm talk to somebody."
Right.
It really can change everything.
It really can. Because
you have what you get a whole wealth of people here that's
right,
going to support you, that's understand you, want to help you,
right,
want to help you to be your best be you that you can be.
Right.
And we understand you coming here, you're upset one day, and it's okay. It's okay. You know, but maybe not at home, maybe
right,
not at home with your family, but here in this environment, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. So you know, we can take the mask off and you can let it all out at the VA.
Well, let me tell you, I have since my time seeking help. It has done wonders for me. And I will tell you, so that's one reason why I enjoy doing this show and really help getting this information out. Because I can honestly tell you, while doing a psychological evaluation to join a federal law enforcement agency, I literally almost threw the evaluator out the second floor window because I had snap. Literally. Needless to say, I didn't get the job.
That's okay, God.
You have another practice.
That I wanted that And I wasn't wrong. I wasn't wrong when I did it. I mean, like you said, we're never wrong. But I look back and I say, wow, I was really crazy. But the services that you guys do offer, and I'm going to tell you, I'd really encourage all parents to really use it. Literally, it's granted, at one time we used to say, hey, we look weak if we sought out the services of social workers. And but that's not so. And, you know, I really tell parents, it has done. I never thought I'd be in broadcasting, but it's because of my work with social workers and with the VA system that allowed me to go out and do the things that I'm going to be talking to all these millions of people. And I was really one that didn't want to be bothered, you know. And I still find times where I'll get out and talk to them, interact with them, and then I'll shut down. And I have those things, that those moments in time, but I'm able to identify that, you know. And at one time, I remember one social worker I worked with out of Detroit. He said, James, you're wearing masks. You have a different mask for everything, you know, associated with different situations. And I'm able now to identify when I'm putting on those masks. And it's like, wow. So I really applaud you guys. You don't know how much this means to me, helping you guys get this information out, because a lot of veterans are in that boat that I was in. And I do know a lot of them that are in it. And a lot of them, they really, because of my show's format, I know that I get a lot of viewers or veterans. I interact with them a great deal. A lot of them are readers of every article that I put on the website. And so they're very active. I definitely want a lot of them to recommend homeless veterans, because we all know someone that is homeless. And I can tell you just from my life growing up, this part definitely means a lot to me, because at one time I was homeless for many years. So, like I said, I will make sure a lot of people take advantage of that, especially veterans, and definitely your son, because they interact. You know, I'm sitting here like, man, these guys, VA really, however they thought of this system, they really came up with a good program to make every department overlap, where you guys can actually help with everything that's situated with that particular veteran. But let's remind them again about suicide prevention, because
yes, there will be a suicide prevention conference on Friday, September 15th on our Tuskegee campus.
Now, will you guys be able to, like I said, if the veterans come here, be able to transport them out there? And also, will it, to this stand down, will they be able to be transported from here?
There are shuttles that run from the Montgomery campus to Tuskegee. I believe they run every hour. And they would need to catch the early shuttle, at least I'd say 7 o'clock at the latest, because the program would start at 8 o'clock.
And it's 8 to what?
It's from 8 until 4.
That's
a long day.
But it's a great topic.
But again, great topic. They can listen to whatever portions they want to listen to. Like I said, the veteran would talk about his journey. It'll be the first one in the morning. PTSD treatment will be second. After lunch, there'll be substance abuse. And the last one will be veterans that are going to college, what their particular struggles are. So they can time it. They either choose to attend the whole thing, or they can come to whatever portion they think might be most helpful for them. And so we're very excited to have this on. And it's Friday, September 15th on our Tuskegee campus, Building 90, which is referred to as our canteen.
Right.
We have a huge auditorium in there, and so we're much, much looking forward to veterans as well as our community partners to come out to this conference. For professionals, contact hours will be offered for veterans of the school to come out and
right.
Get the information.
Now, professionals, that's
Anyone that's licensed, a licensed social worker, a psychologist, a marriage and family therapist, a counselor, a psychiatrist, a doctor, a dentist, a physical therapist, anyone with a license can come and receive contact hours credits. That's done through our nursing education department. So we're looking forward to those professionals to come so they can know, again, how to work with veterans and how to refer to us. It's beyond their scope of practice. But for the veterans, it's free. And so, again, we're looking forward to both populations coming to attend our suicide prevention conference on Friday, September 15th.
Again, those both conferences, the Homeless Veterans Stand Down, as well as the Suicide Prevention Conference, will be on our website. That's talktoalabama.com. We will also have information being broadcast, whether it be live reads or PSAs, throughout the day on 1300 WTLS and 106.5 FM as well. So please take advantage of these informational conferences. They're definitely going to be something that's well worth attending. The Homeless Veterans Stand Down is September 7th and 8th at the Crampton Bowl from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. You have to pre-register at 1-800-214-8387. Again, that's 1-800-214-8387, extension 2549. And for the Suicide Prevention Conference, which is being held September 15th at the Tuskegee Campus, Building 90, which is known as the Canteen, do they have to pre-register?
No, they don't. The veterans can just come. Professionals, we will, if they want to come, they need to contact Adrian Irving at va.gov. We're going to be doing e-bites, which means we're going to be sending the information to them via their website address, their email address. And that'll be a way for us to keep track of who's coming and so that we can know and invite them officially to attend. So if you will contact Adrian Irving at va.gov, she spells her name Adrienne.Irving, E-R-V-I-N, at va.gov.
Great. Now, password, 2 minutes.
In 2 minutes, I'd just like to say, would just like to say that our slogan this year is Be There. We want to be able to be there for our veterans. All of us, from our housekeeping staff, to our director, to our social workers, to our medical doctors, our therapists, we want to be there for our veterans. I don't know if you remember that song Michael Jackson sang years ago, Be There in the Morning.
Right.
We want to be there in the morning for you, be there in the afternoon, be there for you in the midnight hour. That's what we want to be able to do for our veterans.
Okay, I just want to say the Homeless Standdown. I do want to encourage people to pre-register. You asked a question about transportation earlier.
Right.
We'll be providing transportation, but it will help us to know how many people I pick up show time. It will help us to get veterans to pre-register if they're homeless.
Okay.
If not, they can walk up to the event, but the pre-registration allows us to kind of screen them, turn pay if we need to pick you up,
right.
Or get the are you eligible for the services? So we definitely encourage you to pre-register if they can, but if they need to walk up and show up, that's fine. We'll have eligibility to kind of verify things. That's fine. Also, too, just want to say thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to be on the show, to be here, and we just look forward to working with you in the future and helping us with the information out so we can serve our veterans.
Great, great. Again, September 7th and 8th, the Homeless Veterans Stand Down will be held at the Crampton Bowl right there here in Montgomery. And September 15th at Tuskegee Campus, we will have the Suicide Prevention Conference. So please take advantage of these great opportunities. They will be on talktoalabama.com and will be broadcast throughout until their actual events on 1300 AM and 106.5 FM from Central Alabama Veterans Healthcare Center. From Karen and Ian, thank you for being on the show.
Thank you.
I want to thank you for tuning in to 1300 AM and 106.5 FM and those who are viewing us live on WTLS.